Porcelain lizards? They look new. Out of place with the rest of this old beat-up stuff.
Are you prepared to suffer to save your son? You have 5 minutes to cut off the last section of one of your fingers in front of the camera. If you succeed, you will get your reward.
Thank you. That's affirmative, Lieutenant. We're in position.
Perfect. Nobody moves until I give this signal. Is that clear? We nail him as soon as he sets foot outside.
Right, Lieutenant.
Lucky that patrol spotted his car.
What's he doing in there?
Beats me. You're the profiler, right? I thought you were supposed to be right inside the killer's head.
Well, that's just it. What I know of Ethan Mars doesn't match the killer's psychological profile.
I know what the jury's gonna choose between your theories and concrete proof. Girl doing there? Mars comes out now, she's gonna be in trouble.
What do we do, Lieutenant? Want to get her out?
No, stand down. Going inside. Maybe she lives there. Mars just as well. We don't want anyone hanging around if Mars comes out.
Ethan, what happened? The police. They're out there. I think they're here to arrest you. We've got to find another way out.
Shit. What's he up to in there? Wait for a go on my word.
They're still out there. We've got to find another way.
Ready on my go. Stay here, Jayden.
Out of the question. I'm coming with you.
Two men at the door, hold your positions. It's a go.
Come on, let's go this way.
Yeah.
can.
Hands in the air!
Shit. Lieutenant, there's a man and a woman exiting the alley.
A woman? Shit! It's that girl who went in! Everybody downstairs! They're in the alley! Follow them!
The subway.
Less than an hour ago, we heard from the police who have identified the man thought to be the Origami Killer. Ethan Mars, father of the kidnapped victim Sean Mars, is on the run and should be considered armed and dangerous. A police manhunt is now underway, and they hope that they will soon be able to announce the apprehension of this dangerous lunatic.
I brought some food. I didn't know what you like, so I brought some of everything. I hope that's okay.
Why are you helping me, Madison? You know nothing about me. You could have been killed.
I don't know. I guess it just seemed like the right thing to do at the time. You needed help, I helped you. You're all over the news reports, Ethan. Every cop in the country will be hunting you. They say you're the Origami Killer. Is it true? Are you the killer, Ethan?
I sometimes have these blackouts. Times where I don't know what I'm doing. As if I'm someone completely different. The only thing I remember afterwards is the bodies. The bodies in the water.
Why are you hurt, Ethan? Why were you in that apartment?
I think my other self is testing me, testing my love for Sean. He wants to know if I love my son enough to save him. That means there's some part of me that knows where Sean is. But the only way to find him is to go through these trials.
Why can't you tell that to the police?
And tell them what? That I'm a schizophrenic who drowned his victims and has kidnapped his own son? They'd never let me go, and I have to stay free to save Sean. I have no choice. I'm his only chance. When Sean is out of danger, I'll turn myself in, but not until then.
You can't keep going like this. You're destroying yourself, Ethan.
Finding Sean is the only thing that matters.
There has to be another way.
You don't understand. Time is running out. Sean will be dead in a few hours. I have no choice! Please, Madison, leave. Forget everything that's happened. There is nothing more you can do for me. If you want to help me, leave. Leave me to do this on my own.
Your vodka, sir.
Thanks.
You look preoccupied, if you don't mind my saying so. Problems with the investigation?
Blake is convinced that Mars is the killer.
Not you. I thought there was some evidence to that effect.
That's true. But it just doesn't make sense. His psychological profile doesn't fit. Neither does the geolocalization. I can't see this father drowning 8 victims before kidnapping his own kid. Mars is not the Aragami killer. I'd stake my life on it.
Then who is?
I haven't the faintest fucking idea.
Maybe you should review the evidence in your possession.
That's just what I was thinking of doing.
Oh, one last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you-know-what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous.
I'm trying to keep a handle on it, but that's difficult. It gets more and more difficult.
It'll end up killing you if you're not careful. That would be most unfortunate, sir.
Well, well. Looks like there's something new.
The video recording from near the park on the afternoon Sean Mars disappeared. I doubt there's anything on it, but you never know. A Chevrolet model corresponding to its tire prints passed at 1602 heading for the park. When in the opposite direction at 1637, that could fit the time that Sean Mars disappeared. Could it be the killer's car? Pity we can't see the driver's face. The car was stolen. Let's see, a certain Jackson Neville was suspected of stealing it, but the charges were dropped. Not enough evidence. Jackson Neville, a.k.a. Mad Jack, involved in several cases of buying and selling stolen vehicles. Considered to be very dangerous. This guy might have provided the killer with a car. It's a pretty slim lead, but it's all I have right now.
One last thing, sir. You should be careful not to overindulge in you-know-what. It can be dangerous. Very dangerous.
Shit. It's coming. Triptocaine. The tube is on the bedside table. All I need is to take some, and the pain will go away. I should resist. This is gonna kill me. I know I can resist. I just need to stay in control and do something until it goes away.
Manfred! Manfred! Anybody home? Hi there, Manfred.
Who is it?
Scott. Scott Shelby. Do you remember me?
Scott? It's Scott! Oh, yeah, of course. Well, good to see you. How long has it been?
Oh, about 10 years, I guess.
Oh, at my age, time means nothing anymore. I repair clocks, but I try to forget about time. How about you? Are you still with the police?
Oh, no, I quit. I'm a private investigator now. This is Lauren. She's a friend.
Hello.
Oh, hello, young lady. Well, this calls for a celebration. I've just the thing. Wait there. I'm sure I saw a bottle of scotch around here somewhere. Do an old man a favor, would you, Scott? Tell him to call back this afternoon.
Sure, no problem. Hello? Yeah, this is Manfred's. He's not available right now. Could you call back later this afternoon? Thanks.
Well, to old friends.
I'd like you to have a look at an envelope. I thought maybe you could tell me about the typewriter that was used to type the address on it.
Well, let's have a look. Now, could you pass me the magnifying glass from behind the counter?
Oh, sure, please. I'll get it.
My eyes are beginning to fail me. Thanks. Well, let's see what this envelope has to say for itself. The Royal Five. Yes, the shape of the T's and the F's is typical of that model. Produced between 1907 and 1924. Yes. No doubt about it. It's a Royal Five.
These typewriters, are they rare?
No, they're fairly common. I'd say many folks have one gathering dust in an attic or in their cellar.
Do you keep a record of all your clients?
Oh, yes, indeed. At least the ones who pay.
Any chance I could get a peek at that?
Yes, of course. I keep my account books in the office. If you're not in a hurry, I have a list of all the clients who ever bought a Royal Five or had one repaired.
Yeah, that would really help us out.
Delighted to help. Give me 2 minutes, and I'll be right back with the list.
You think the killer's been here?
If he has a 1920s typewriter, he may have needed Manfred's services to get it fixed. We'll know when we get the list.
Hello?
Manfred!
Hello? Your call is locked, sir. A police car will be there in a few minutes. I need to know who you are, sir. Sir? Hello?
Oh my God! He's dead. Oh. Has already called the police. I think he wants us to be his scapegoats. We gotta get the hell out of here.
What do you mean? We have nothing to do with his death. We were just here when it happened.
Look, we're running out of time to find Sean Mars. The last thing we need is 24 hours in a police station explaining this whole thing.
Well, so what do we do?
Watch the front door. I'll get rid of our fingerprints from everything we touched since we came in. You better work fast. The police are going to be here any minute. What are you doing, Lauren? If someone comes in, we're going to be in trouble.
These are Manfred's account books. He must have been looking for owners of Royals when he was killed.
Forget it. We got to get out of here fast. I'm almost finished.
That's it. We're done.
You get all the prints?
I got what I got. It should be enough to prevent them from finding us. Come on, let's go.
Where are we going?
I'm taking you home. This is getting way too dangerous.
No way. We're partners, remember? We had a deal.
Listen, Lauren, I know you want to find the killer, but you're not helping me by putting yourself in danger.
I'm not a child. I know what I have to do. I've got to find my son's killer. You're not going to stop me.
Well, then you can find him without me. I refuse to be responsible for anything that goes wrong.
Stop the fucking car!
This girl's stubborn as a mule. She doesn't let up, with or without me. Crap, I have no choice. I guess I'm doing this to protect her. I can't just leave her like that. She'd do anything to find the guy who killed her son.
Lauren!
Miss him so much. I'd do anything to hold him once again in my arms.